This is the Modi Diaries. Today, we keep our focus on the northeastern part of the country. The biggest democracy in the world is swiftly heading into the election season, with the first phase scheduled on 19th of April, less than 15 days from now. In light of that, we bring you the Modi Diaries, which is a special telecast where we walk you through the endeavors of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's 9 years of leadership. In this special telecast, we will be focusing on the Prime Minister's efforts to make northeastern states Vikasit and Atmanirbhar. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has time and again described and displayed his pride for the northeastern states, and oftentimes seen sporting traditional attire in the northeastern regions, visiting these areas, promoting local handicrafts and encouraging tourism. By dedicating Sikkim's first Indian railway station in Rangpo, inaugurating the Sela Tunnel in Arunachal Pradesh, and unveiling Northeast's first Vande Bharat train connecting Guwahati to New Jalpaiguri, the Prime Minister has enhanced connectivity and reached the last mile in the northeastern states. Many schemes launched by the Prime Minister have been life-changing in Northeast, such as the Prime Minister Jan Dhan Yojana, which has beneficiaries of over 2.8 crores across the seven sisters. So, well, the question that looms large, has the Prime Minister been successful in bridging the northeastern gap? Are the efforts of the Prime Minister going to impact the 2024 Lok Sabha results? Let's quickly take a recap of the 10 years that the Prime Minister has governed the country and his focus on look east and act east, and how this has been implemented in the truest sense, allowing for the welfare, for the development, and for the people to then improve their lives and livelihoods. Let's start our conversation. Joining me on the telecast right now is Pramod Swamy, BJP spokesperson. Pramod Swamy, quickly a word from you about, you know, the northeastern regions, where at one point of time the narrative used to be that Northeast is cut off from the rest of the country. Do you feel that BJP and particularly Prime Minister have done enough to ensure this narrative is turned around on its head? And not just that, but there have been outreach programs that have been made, the welfare schemes that have been launched across the length and breadth of the country, in the rest of the country, are also given to the people of the northeastern states.
बिल्कुल देखिए एक समय नॉर्थ ईस्ट की जो पहचान थी वो धरना प्रदर्शन आतंकवाद के लिए नॉर्थ ईस्ट की पहचान थी लेकिन माननीय प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी के नेतृत्व में आज तस्वीर बदली है और नॉर्थ ईस्ट जो है आज विकास के पथ पर अग्रसर है माननीय प्रधानमंत्री नॉर्थ ईस्ट को अष्टलक्ष्मी कहकर के संबोधित करते हैं और आपने जो अभी जो वंदे भारत एक्सप्रेस के बारे में बात कही तो मैं कहना चाहूंगा कि 2014 के पहले जो रेलवे का जो बजट था वो नॉर्थ ईस्ट के लिए 2000 करोड़ रुपया था लेकिन एनडीए की सरकार आने के बाद में आज वो बजट जो है 10,200 करोड़ रुपए का बजट जो है वो रेलवे के लिए हमने निर्धारित किया है पहले 2013-14 तक जो नेशनल हाईवे में सड़कों का निर्माण था यूपीए के समय में वो 8,480 किलोमीटर था जो आज बढ़कर करके 2022-23 में 15,735 किलोमीटर हो गया पहले आपको नॉर्थ ईस्ट के समय यूपीए के समय में 13 फाइनेंस कमीशन में नॉर्थ ईस्ट को 87,000 करोड़ रुपए अलॉट किए गए थे और 14 फाइनेंस कमीशन में मोदी जी ने 3,13,375 करोड़ रुपए नॉर्थ ईस्ट के लिए अलॉट किए हैं तो ये जो डेवलपमेंट की जो गाथा है ये अपने आप में काफी महत्वपूर्ण है और पहले जो लुक ईस्ट पॉलिसी थी लुक ईस्ट पॉलिसी के तहत नॉर्थ ईस्ट की तरफ सिर्फ देखा जाता था लेकिन मोदी जी के आने के बाद में एक्ट ईस्ट पॉलिसी आई और माननीय प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने प्रधानमंत्री बनने के बाद में कम से कम 60 बार नॉर्थ ईस्ट का दौरा किया इसके पहले किसी प्रधानमंत्री ने नॉर्थ ईस्ट का दौरा 60 बार से ज्यादा नॉर्थ ईस्ट का दौरा नहीं किया है आज हर केंद्रीय मंत्री 15 दिन में एक बार नॉर्थ ईस्ट पे आता है प्रवास करता है यहाँ की समस्याओं के बारे में जानकारी लेता है और उसके समाधान का प्रयास करता है आज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कहिए कनेक्टिविटी कहिए डेवलपमेंट कहिए, इस सारी दिशाओं में आज जो नॉर्थ ईस्ट जो है प्रगति के पथ पर अग्रसर है, और इसी वजह से आज नॉर्थ ईस्ट में शांति भी है, प्रगति भी है, क्योंकि हमारे पास नीति भी है, नेतृत्व भी है और नियत भी है।
जी,
मैं ये नहीं कहता कि पहले के नेताओं के पास नीति नहीं थी, नेतृत्व नहीं था, लेकिन उनके पास नियत नहीं थी।
Let me also get my other panelists. You've made your point and thank you for sharing all those statistics and data that gives us a clear picture. Joining me also is the NPP spokesperson, M. Shankpaliang. Thank you so much, Mr. Shankpaliang, for joining us on the telecast. And quickly, a word from you. How have the northeastern states, and particularly Meghalaya, improved over the last 10 years, particularly when the schemes that have been launched at the central level, have they been able to reach the state level?
Well, thank you so much. Basically, I'd like to thank this channel to have got me into this conversation today. My name is Himalaya M. Shankpaliang, H.M. Shankpaliang. So I am the spokesperson of the National People's Party in Meghalaya, which is also a national party. In the last 6 years, I should say, that 2018 onwards, when the NPP-led government, which also has a coalition with a few other parties in the state, few regional parties, including the BJP, has been able to bring drastic changes in the state in the terms of road and communication, in terms of development in the health sector, the education sector, and the relationship that the party has with the BJP has been as old as the days of late Purno A. Sangma and late Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji. That was the days when late P.A. Sangma, Purno Sangma, was also a candidate of the NDA for the presidential elections. So you can track down the history of the alliance and the relationship that we have along with the mainstream. That's why we have been able to see a lot of changes. And even this time, the BJP has not set up any candidate for the two parliamentary seats in Meghalaya. It is an understanding with the NPP that the NPP being a partner in the alliance, the BJP is giving all out support to get more votes for the candidates of the NPP in both the seats. So therefore, we look forward for a good relationship and good development that we look forward for the next, for the second term, I should say. The first term led by Conrad Sangma and the second term as well led by Conrad Sangmaji. So therefore, we hope that with the concept of double engine that we have, we hope that we are going to get more funds and more resources and more development for the rural poor.
Okay. Mr. Shankpaliang, which are the schemes and development projects that have most resonated with the people of Meghalaya?
You see, madam, to name the scheme, there are so much, so plenty of them. We have, our people have benefited a lot in the PMAY. The PMAY in those days earlier, there was hardly just about 30,000 houses in a year or 40,000 in a year. But this time around, you won't believe it, we got a sanction of more than 1,30,000 houses for the rural poor. That goes to, it's going to really benefit the people and is going to speak a lot about the way that the central government is helping the rural poor. Then we have the Jal Jeevan Mission. In the Jal Jeevan Mission, every village, every household has a water tap connection. I mean, this kind of changes has never been there in the previous years. And people understand, people benefit. Now you see at the Ujwala scheme, now there you get free gas connections. They get the Modi rise Even now, the rice is being distributed. Therefore, to name, there's so many of them, but the benefits have really gone down to the grassroots.
Okay. I also have with me Sumit Peer, and viewing what our spokespersons have said and the larger picture that Prime Minister has painted for the Northeastern region, moving, as my other panelists said, from look east to act east. And this has not just involved the Northeastern states domestically, but also opened avenues and territories to the ASEAN nations for a broader Northeast, for a broader Act East connect.
Megha ji, thank you for having me on your show. You know, the India you and me were born of, though I was born much years earlier than you, there was a glass wall. There was a glass wall between the India and Northeast. Let's be candid about it. It's only in 2014, after Prime Minister Modi came in, that glass wall stands shattered today. There is no glass wall between the Northeast and rest of India. That is the biggest credit which goes singularly to Prime Minister Modi, his visionary leadership. What is the proof of the ground? The proof of the ground is that today in most of the states you have a BJP government, though have a Christian majority, still there's a BJP government there. That means that Northeast has seen a visible change. They've seen a change of development. Now, if we talk of development, the first major change they saw, electricity to everybody. There were a lot of areas of Northeast where electricity had never reached. LPG to everybody. There were a lot of areas where LPG had never reached. Then you had all-weather connectivity. Then you have these Sela tunnels, the mega infrastructure projects. You have the dam builds. The biggest dam in the India is being built in Arunachal Pradesh. You know, these seven sisters were unfortunately neglected, and people is theek hai, you know, we will live with it. Now, I have to say that there was also a kind of a racial bias between the Northeast and rest of India. Prime Minister Modi was not happy with it. If you look at Mr. Kiran Rijiju, he has been always getting significant positions in the cabinet of Mr. Modi that talks about his commitment to Northeast. If you look at Mr. Hemant Biswa Sarma, if you look at Mr. Sonowal, if you look at all these leaders, they've been getting very prominent positions. So the Northeast is very adequately represented. Now, if you look at the one initiative of Prime Minister Modi was organic farming. Organic farming, he was the person who got organic farming started in that. And Sikkim is the place where it is booming and blossoming. Another major contribution was that access to the Chittagong port. Because traditionally, the Northeast had to come to Guwahati, then Calcutta. From Calcutta, the things used to move out. Now, with the access to the Chittagong port and the, you know, this multimodal kind of corridor built to the Chittagong port, that is again a big thing because that helps to increase the, productivity and economy of the Northeast. Now, building of dams, building of fish, new oil excavation in Northeast, looking for rare earth minerals and all that, is a lot of excavations are going in Northeast. Getting education to the Northeast, look how many IITs, how many IIMs, how many higher institutions, how many medical colleges have opened under the leadership of Prime Minister Modi there. And here the beauty is, you might be in a power in a state or you might not be in a power of the state, but he is there, a dedicated ministry for Northeast. I mean, there was a time almost every day there was some minister or the other cabinet minister who was camping in Northeast. Prime Minister Modi's visits to Northeast, the connect with the Northeast, and whenever he goes, he wears the local attire and all, he connects with the people. Now, you see the love which Prime Minister Modi has got. Look at the history of it. No other Prime Minister has got that level of love. No other Prime Minister has that kind of connect on the ground. And what are the achievements? The biggest achievement is biggest ever surrenders of those militants and all happened in the Northeast. The Northeast is a much peaceful place. If you look at National Crime Bureau's statistics, the terror incidents, the grenade incidents, and all those have come drastically down. They had some problems in Manipur, but they were there was a Chinese hand in it. China and Pakistan and some vested powers who tried to influence us there. If you look at the use of drugs, that there was a lot of opium which was cultivated there. That opium is being destroyed. Those khetis of opium are completely destroyed. If you look at this, a stance of mainstreaming Northeast, when a child from here goes to IIT in Guwahati or a child from Guwahati comes to Bangalore, that is the mainstreaming of Northeast. If you see the process in 10 years, we have achieved what we could not achieve in the last 65 years. That is the main credit of Prime Minister Modi. And when the people of the Northeast, even in Christian majority states, see the development delivered, that is the Modi's mantra. Mm. That is why the BJP is voted again and again and again in power. And the people who have been traditionally trying to be the guardians of the Northeast, like Congress and all, they are voted out of the power. They are nowhere to be seen. They are losing ground and all. This is the Modi magic of development delivered without any bias, without any perceptions, without any preconceived notions. Sabka saath, sabka vikas, sabka priyas. and sabka sabha, you know, prayas. And that is what has worked the magic in Northeast. People are appreciating the development delivered. Youth are happy.
Absolutely. Pramod, one more important point, and that has perhaps also shifted the government's attention to Northeastern region, about the skirmishes that have happened in Galwan, in the Northeastern region, about the number of times China has exerted its dominance in Arunachal Pradesh. These are border states. When we go and build the Sela Tunnel in Arunachal Pradesh, when there are connectivity projects to allow for our military troops and allow for the deployment of vehicles to pass through, that automatically helps in developing the regions, developing the infrastructure. How important was it to be done perhaps 20 or 30 years ago?
और आपको मैं एक बात बताना चाहता हूं कि एक समय में जो यूपीए की सरकार थी तो उनके जो रक्षा मंत्री थे एके एंथोनी साहब, उन्होंने पार्लियामेंट में कहा था कि हम बॉर्डर एरिया में इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर को हम मजबूत नहीं करेंगे। हम इसलिए नहीं करेंगे कि अगर बॉर्डर एरिया में हम इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर को मजबूत करते हैं तो चाइना उसका फायदा उठाएगा। ये हमारी मानसिकता थी, ये हमारा माइंडसेट था। लेकिन अभी आपने जो जिस बात का जिक्र किया कि आप देखिए बॉर्डर एरिया में इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर को मजबूत किया जा रहा है, टनलों का निर्माण हो रहा है, उससे इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर मजबूत होने से वहां के वहां विकास तो होगा ही, लेकिन हमारी सामरिक शक्ति भी बढ़ी है। अगर आज वहां कोई अगर वार की स्थिति उत्पन्न हो जाती है तो जिस तरह से इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर मजबूत हुआ है, जिस तरह से टनलों का निर्माण हुआ है, हमारी सेनाएं बहुत ही कम समय में अपने जो 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 फ्रंट पे पहुंच सकती है। तो ये जब नेतृत्व बदला है तो नीति बदली है तो देखिए अभी परिणाम आपको सामने नजर आ रहे हैं कि पूरी मानसिकता बदल गई है। और आज उसी मानसिकता की वजह से भारत जो है, भारत की जो सैन्य शक्ति, भारत की सैन्य शक्ति पहले भी मजबूत थी, लेकिन जब भारत का पॉलिटिकल जो नेतृत्व है उसने जो दृढ़ इच्छा शक्ति थी दिखाई, उसका परिणाम आप देखिए आज बॉर्डर पे हमारे जवान सीना तान करके खड़े हैं। और डकलम जैसी जगह पर जहां चाइना के साथ में कभी कभी हमारा जो कंफ्रंटेशन होता है, हमने उनका मुंह तोड़, हमारे सेना के जवानों ने उनका मुंह तोड़ जवाब दिया है। ये है बदली हुई सोच, ये है बदला हुआ नेतृत्व, और ये है नया भारत। माननीय प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी के नेतृत्व में ये नया भारत है। हम पड़ोसी देशों से सौहार्दपूर्ण रिलेशन चाहते हैं, अच्छे संबंध चाहते हैं, लेकिन अगर कोई ये सोचेगा कि भारत जो है, भारत में कोई कमजोरी है तो ये उसकी भूल है। भारत ईंट का जवाब पत्थर से देने में आज माननीय प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी के नेतृत्व में सक्षम है।
योर पॉइंट मिस्टर शंख प्रियांक, आई कम बैक टू यू नाउ। ऑल्सो Now, we've seen what the past 10 years under BJP have been, under NDA have been, in the northeastern states particularly. Now, if a voter was to vote for the BJP in anticipation of what the next 5 years are going to look like, what is it that is going to be further improved under Prime Minister Narendra Modi's vigilance, under Prime Minister Narendra Modi's vision in the northeastern states? What more needs to be done?
Well, you heard in detail what Pramod ji has just mentioned about the visions and the dreams of the Prime Minister. Now, the northeast is still to be developed a lot. What you see is just the main big cities like Guwahati, Shillong, and other cities, which are very few in the northeast. But if you really go to the rural areas, I think there are lots to be done. The most concerning, which is required, is the mobile connectivity. Now this is the world of online classes, online registrations of Aadhaar, online registration of PMAY schemes, and all centralized schemes are to be registered online. Now, if a poor villager who stays in the rural areas, particularly in the hilly region where the connectivity is very poor, then how is he going to enjoy the benefits like any other plains people enjoy.
Mm-hmm.
This is one major drawback where I feel in the next 5 years that Modi ji is going to come back to the power, and he has to take care of the mobile connectivity of the people. This is where, because we have experienced the hardship here during during the COVID times, there were so many things that we have to be done online. We had a lot of problems.
Mm-hmm.
Then again, now you could see Aadhaar has been made compulsory that you have to register online. Now, any scheme is Aadhaar linked. Now, how do they link it up when the connectivity is totally nil? It's not even poor. So therefore, my appeal is, these are certain, some of the priorities. There are more. What we require is roads, connectivity. Then we require bridges. Then we require, you know, such infrastructures like good schools, good hospitals. And these are going to really help the people in the rural poor.
Okay. Sumit, you know, I'm going to again talk about the security issue. The borders are very sensitive. We take a look at Manipur, where there has been insurgency, where there has been drug trafficking, when there has been arms trafficking as well. And that has been sensitized right now. The situation has, the government has tried to control it. There is already barricading that has taken place, fencing that has been allowed in that entire 1400 kilometer stretch. In similar vein, when we talk about Ladakh, that has also been a point of concern for the BJP. This particularly after the union territory status was accorded to it. The question continues to arise as to when are elections going to be allowed and there is full statehood provided to Ladakh, which has also been a concern. So on one hand, you have abrogation of Article 370, which is a complete game changer, a transformation for Jammu and Kashmir and by default in Ladakh as well. The next move that the BJP will be asked to make by the people of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh would be regaining their statehood.
Yes. Meghaji, let me take you a little bit back into the time. Traditionally, thousands of crores of aid has been going, packages have been given to J&K. What was happening? 90% will go to Kashmir, 8% will go to Jammu, 2% will go to Ladakh. For the first time, you and me, even on national TV, we are talking Ladakh, because Ladakh never counted in the electoral game of erstwhile state of Jammu and Kashmir. Now, as a union territory, they will have their existence, they will have their right, they will have their say, they will have their demands. When they were part of Jammu and Kashmir, nobody bothered about them because at an electoral level, they did not really count. Now, restoration of statehood is a promise which the Honorable Prime Minister and Mr. Amit Shah has made. Elections will be held at the due point of time when we are sure that the security needs and other things are pretty much taken care of. We don't have to forget, we have a very dangerous and a hostile neighbor, China. On the other side, we have a Pakistan. And even if you look at some places, these both work together. So considering the geopolitical situations which are happening, especially in China and all, the people of the Ladakh have to be assured that when it is going to happen, they are going to get their say down. They are going to get what is due to them. They are going to get what the potential of the place is. I believe if you talk of the Ladakh, if you talk of the Northeast, you know, there is huge tourist potential in both the places. If you talk of Northeast, Northeast can be a huge economic hub. It can be the world's basket of organic farming. If it cannot be Northeast, there's no other place. It can be the organic, the bamboo is very good there. Fisheries are very good there because you have a lot of water bodies. I have a friend who has two small power plants in Sikkim. So generation of hydropower. So similarly for Ladakh, skating, you know, tourism, then software technology parks and other things which have to come up in due course of time.
Mm-hmm.
But the people have to understand, we are battling China, we are battling Pakistan, and we are battling some elements within who are trying to weaken the system. So in this three triangle battle, the best thing, or the silver lining in the cloud is that Ladakh has its own entity, own say, and we are talking Ladakh earlier, which was not there. So when you have your own say and identity, in due course of time, you're going to get what is due to you. So that is going to come. They have to be a little bit patient,
yeah,
because it is a promise by the Honorable Home Minister. It's a promise by the Honorable Prime Minister in the Parliament. So there is no way it cannot be done. It will be done.
Right.
And whatever is happening for the good of people of Ladakh,
right,
and Northeast.
Absolutely.
I have no doubt on that.
Absolutely. All right. I only have as much time. I thank all of you for joining me on the telecast.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.